Hey, Cassie, thanks for your email. See the problem. You even call yourself out on the problem in it, but you talk about all the twists and turns and the pivots with the economy, as well as you say, don't call it stupidity. This is a product of many entrepreneurs, many type A personalities. You talk about your shaved ice trailer, and then the kettle corn equipment, and then a brick and mortar in the mall, and then a concession trailer, and then a hot dog cart, and then an ice cream truck, and then the fair setups, and then you talk about the Italian ice, and what else here? Nachos on the food truck, and the sausages and dirty water, the pulled pork nachos. And you say, I really want to grow this into being a food trailer. I'm already tired of switching of the menu from one event to the next. I get that. And you talk about being all these years, you feel that you should already be in a better place. And this happens. You've heard of the grass is greener on the other side, and the shiny object. I've written some articles about the shiny object, and I'm at fault for the same. So it's like the pot calling the kettle black in this situation. It's do as I say, not as I do kind of mentality. But I want you to know, I have a friend named Alex Hormozy that says that a big fault of any entrepreneur is the shiny object attracting our attention. And then you start to adapt and you go, oh man, this is doing good, and then I'm gonna do this. Well, he gave a story recently in the last year, and he said, you know, he had a buddy that had multiple businesses, like 50 businesses, and he asked to know why. Oh, I'll make a lot of money with all those businesses. Would you make more on one if you just focused all of your time and effort on one? The answer was, of course, yes. And he said his friend debated this for a year and finally did it. He sold everything and kept one business and became hugely successful in that business. So it's the same with this. We've talked about this before in our Vendors United group. We talk about this quite frequently, because a vendor will start and go, man, I'm doing good with the lemonade. I'm making good money, but dang, that guy's got funnel cakes over there. I'm going to start doing funnel cakes too. And you start spreading yourself too thin. And the gist is, it's not that that's a bad thing to open a new enterprise with it or add a product. It means having this one so successful that you can afford the help and the people you need to make all that happen. The ones that are super successful, they make a plan, and then work the plan, stick to the plan, and focus all your energy into one thing and make that grow. It doesn't mean you can't have five items in your food trailer, but if that's what you want to work, then focus there. If you want the kettle corn to work, focus there, because there's many people making a ton of money on just kettle corn, is doing popcorn, and has been doing it for years, and how he started with a Whirly Pop on top of a stove, and he is still shipping popcorn all over the country, all because of that. Now that he's good at that, but now he doesn't really want to. Well, why not keep dancing with the person that brought you to the party kind of thing? And he makes plenty of money there, so he doesn't try to venture out with 17 other projects. He and his family are successful with that. And no matter what you choose to be successful with, you will be if you put all your energy into it. The problem is, if you got five different things going, like you kind of did, you kept changing, you're putting all your energy into this one for a little bit, but leaves this one over here lacking any attention, or the attention it needs to keep growing. It's best if you can focus on what your goal is, create a goal, and go, okay, my goal is, according to your email, I want the food truck to be successful. You talk about that you don't have any savings right now and that you have some personal debt. This comes from this, there's two things that cause this: spending more than we make, or spending exactly what we make, and too many items that our attention goes to, so that nothing gets 100% of our attention. And that's the problem. You want to focus 100% on that food trailer to make it successful. You can. You've done this long enough, it should be a shoe-in for you. I mean, you're over a decade and a half into this, and you go, what's happened? Well, you called yourself out. You've been all over the place. Focus on something and grow that something. You said you do the bingo hall or whatever. You can go beyond the bingo hall. You can do all kinds of stuff out of that food trailer and make it successful. It's just what you put your attention to. Don't let every new shiny object, you know, the new lemon smasher, the new this, the new that, take your attention off of your main goal. And if you'll do that, you'll end up like the Jason Browns, the Mark Lawlers, the Ken Packers, who just focus on one. Ken started with hot dogs, got super successful with it. Now he does lemonade too, and he's got people to run them both if he needs it. So it just put all your attention till it can't grow any better, till it just absolutely is the best and you're tickle pink with the results. And then also remember to save money. I don't care if you say you can't save money. All of us can save money. There's a phenomenal book, okay? And it's probably free online somewhere, called The Richest Man in Babylon. And if you will follow the steps, just those two steps in that book, you will have savings. I don't care if you make 30 grand a year or 30 grand a month. If you do these things, you will have money. I've got friends that make three times the money I do and are always broke. And it's because of savings. They spend more than they make, and they make no plan to stick by. So Do those things. And then I would encourage you to invest in the end of Vendors United, because you're investing in yourself, and you will come out miles ahead faster because it cuts out all the learning curves. Now, you've cut out a lot of learning curves over the years. You know how to vend food. Now you just need to focus on your food trailer and do it. And if you need help along the way, I'll be happy to help. But I hope that helps you. I hope that gives you some encouragement. And I hope that you realize, okay, two things I can change, and I'll be calling Ben in a year, and it won't be this conversation. It'll be, oh, I'm kicking butt. Now I want to sell my kettle corn machine, or I want to sell this, and I'm going to just stick to this. And you will be tickled pink with yourself. I look forward to hearing that. I do. So I'll talk to you later. Love you. Bye.